Well, everyone, there's a pandemic all over the world. Coronavirus has arrived. It's like 2019 was there, and we're like, it can't be a worse year. 2020 has to be better, right? 2020 arrives, and they're like, hold my corona. Today, I want to share the best viral outbreak films to watch during a pandemic, the best virus films to watch during the coronavirus. Here we go. There's a lot of viral outbreak movies, a lot of pandemic, epidemic type of films, but the first one that comes to mind is Outbreak from the 90s, starring Dustin Hoffman, Rene Russo, Kevin Spacey. This film is the reason why I'm skeptical and just cautious of monkeys. Monkeys entering the country. Yeah, Ace Ventura's monkey, freaking Patrick Dempsey, brings in a monkey and it creates a viral outbreak. It's a reason why when I go to the movies and I see a person sneeze, I cringe because I just imagine that germ traveling through the auditorium in the theater and just hitting everybody. I really love this movie. It's like basically like what would happen in a mass outbreak. You know, the 90s, you had a lot of natural disaster films or films like this that were just viral outbreak, just hysteria films. And I love it. And it's crazy because you see movies and it's like escape in an orderly fashion. You know what happened in real life? People didn't steal TVs. They didn't steal food. They stole toilet paper. People bought toilet paper. Yeah. That's the one thing you need to stock up on. But Outbreak is an underrated film. And speaking of monkeys, another underrated viral outbreak film is 12 Monkeys, directed by Terry Gilliam, starring Bruce Willis, Brad Pitt, Madeline Stowe. I love this movie. You know, it's a remake of a French short, and I love it. It has a cool twist, but also it's about Bruce Willis traveling back in time and having to stop the 12 Monkeys virus. It all starts with monkeys. It's crazy. I love it. It's one of those cool time loop films with Bruce Willis. So if you're a fan of Looper and stuff like Terminator, you'll definitely like 12 Monkeys. After that is a more recent film named Contagion. Contagion is such a good film with Matt Damon, Gwyneth Paltrow, Marion Cotillard. This is an awesome movie and just a scary film. It's an intense film. And just seeing Matt Damon having to go through like losing his wife due to this virus and being questioned by people, not being affected by it, but seeing the world around him affected is just so intense. After that is a zombie film called Maggie. This is a sad film with Arnold Schwarzenegger dealing with like a zombie outbreak and his daughter is infected. You either have to go to quarantine or you have to kill him. And he keeps the daughter there to spend time with her and he has to basically, he's faced with killing his own daughter once she turns to a zombie. And it's such a great movie. Seeing his daughter just deal with this zombie virus, but seeing him lose someone so close to him. And this is his best performance since Terminator 2. I absolutely love Maggie. This is not only an underrated zombie film, but just a viral outbreak type of family film. And just seeing Arnold Schwarzenegger really use his acting chops outside of comedy and action. Underrated film. After that, speaking of zombies, we have Resident Evil. I love this based on the Biohazard video game. Yeah. The T-Virus, it's an outbreak and it's all in the Hive, the Red Queen. I love this. Nobody does it better than Resident Evil. I'm actually scared of this coronavirus, not because it might be like Stephen King's The Stand, but what if they wake up as zombies? That's why I'm afraid of viruses, thanks to Resident Evil. After that is 28 Days Later and 28 Weeks Later, another underrated viral zombie film. I love the first one of like this guy Killian Murphy plays. He wakes up from a coma and the world has gone to shit. There's zombies everywhere. A viral outbreak happened. And 28 Weeks Later, of course, is 28 weeks later from that. I hope they make a 28 months later or 28 years later down in the future. That would be cool. Very two underrated kind of like Biohazard zombie films. Going more with like a virus causing mutation and monsters, I go with the Omega Man and I Am Legend, both based on the novel. Omega Man and I Am Legend deal with the virus causing people to turn into vampires, and it's about the last man on Earth, which is also a Vincent Price film, but I love these two versions. Omega Man's a bit closer to the novel as far as like the third act, but I love both of them. And yeah, I get kind of scared of that, you know, just talking to people. Are there going to be any audience members out there on YouTube? Am I going to be talking to myself here, being the last man on Earth? Like, that would be crazy. But yeah, two really well done viral outbreak movies. And then similar to that is World War Z with Brad Pitt. I really like it. It's not like the book, but it is kind of a cool PG-13 horror film. Or I actually watched the uncut version, which is rated R. That one is a superior version, so if you watch it, watch the director's cut. Then we go to the film that started it all, Dawn of the Dead from 1978. George A. Romero really started something special here with his like viral outbreak creating zombies, but also having some political stuff there, but not shoving it in your face. It's an undertone to the main horror story, and I love it. I love this movie. It's no wonder it was remade. If Night of the Living Dead started the zombie genre, this elevated it and really solidified George Romero as a horror filmmaker. Then we have films Daybreakers, that is an outbreak movie with vampires. Ethan Hawke, very underrated, where like vampires are running out of human blood and this virus basically made people into nocturnal monsters. And we also have Doomsday, which is pretty much like Mad Max, you know? I love it. This virus just turns people all rabid, and it's a post-apocalyptic film. A very underrated one. If you're a fan of Mad Max, Mad Max Fury Road, stuff like Underworld and Resident Evil, definitely watch Doomsday with Ronan Mitra. Then we have Dreamcatcher, which is more like an alien virus based on a Stephen King novel. It has some disturbing imagery. It's a reason why, like, when I have a stomach ache, I'm afraid to go to the restroom after seeing what happened to Jason Lee in this film. But what can I say? I love Thomas Jane and Stephen King adaptations with this and The Mist, and Dreamcatcher is a really cool alien virus movie. Then we also have Rise of the Planet of the Apes. This is great with the Simian Flu, the Caesar trilogy. I also like Conquest, but Rise of the Apes is kind of cool seeing how like the apes rise, seeing the story of Caesar. James Franco's in it, John Lithgow, and I like seeing how the Simian Flu is not only like elevating the intelligence of these apes, but it also affects the humans, and this is a start of that. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is another good one as well. Then we have Children of Men. This is an underrated Alfonso Cuarón film, and it's pretty much about a world where people become infertile. They cannot reproduce, and they finally find a woman who is pregnant for the first time in many years, and Clive Owen has to protect her. Such a cool look of what would happen if like humans couldn't reproduce and how societies would collapse in like the aftermath of that. Such a great post-apocalyptic film. And then going to post-apocalyptic, it's a bit lighter. We have the Maze Runner series. You know, you have some this devastating virus that just wiped out certain people, and this is the aftermath of that. Again, most of these post-apocalyptic movies are here because of war or just famine and pestilence. And yeah, Maze Runner is a cool kind of more Hunger Games, Twilight-esque type of film, but much more serious than those. Then we have the Michael Crichton classic, The Andromeda Strain, where they go to another planet and have this certain type of strain. Very cool sci-fi virus film. I love it. Going to aliens again, we have Invasion of the Body Snatchers. The original is great, but I recommend the Donald Sutherland one. That one is an excellent film dealing with this alien infection. And then we have another film that's very similar with Donald Sutherland called The Puppet Masters from 1994. I definitely recommend those. Then we have Cabin Fever and Slither, two great horror films with a certain type of infection and people just having to deal with that. Those are two very underrated horror films. And yeah, during a time like this right now, I highly recommend it. Lastly, we have It Comes at Night and Planet Terror. It Comes at Night is a very underrated Joel Edgerton film. It's very different. It's a very different type of viral outbreak film compared to the other ones, you know? You think reading the synopsis is going to be like these type of other films that I've mentioned previously just now. But no, it's a very different type of film. If you want to look for a hidden gem of a horror film, of a virus outbreak film, I recommend that. And then Planet Terror is a film that's, of course, like zombies and vampires before us, but it's part of the Grindhouse double feature, directed by Robert Rodriguez, starring Rose McGowan, Freddy Rodriguez, Michael Biehn. I love this movie. Josh Brolin's in it. This is a cool kind of B-movie viral outbreak film. So definitely check out those films. Those are the films that I recommend would be the best like viral outbreak movies to watch during a pandemic or the coronavirus right now. I'm dealing with sinus. I hope I'm not getting sick. I feel like I'm a germaphobe, but I feel really, really, really kind of like placebo now where I'm just paranoid. Just don't touch me. I'm like that guy in RoboCop, like, get away from me, you know? But anyway, let me know some of your favorite viral outbreak films down in the comments below. And everybody, stay safe out there, wash your hands, and yeah, let's get through this, guys. Here's some more videos to watch on my channel if you're, like me, stuck inside all day. Feel free to subscribe for more videos. Till next time.